Hey, what's up? This is Jamal Abbott here to show you how to set up 8x8 Frontdesk for your environment. This video, we're going to go through the steps to set up Frontdesk as well as show you how to use some basic features and functionality. Just want to show you from the screen right now that I have a normal 8x8 work desktop app on my screen. We're going to activate this to support Frontdesk in the following next scene. So to get started, we're going to go over to our admin console. We have that pulled up on the screen, and we're going to go to users. Now we can enable Frontdesk on any of the users that we want for our organization. So I'm going to be the lucky recipient today of Frontdesk. So we'll go ahead and go over and edit my profile. We're on the basic profile for my account. What we want to key in on is the services and permissions. We actually need to set the applicable license so that way I can have Frontdesk. On the services and permissions page, you see here that I have a couple of different licenses assigned to me. At a minimum, we need an X4 license. And right now, as you can see, I have an X4 and X8. We'll just leave it there at X8. And then just underneath that, you see an option for enable front desk. So for me to have front desk, I click this button and then now save the changes, and front desk is now enabled. So on this next scene, we're going to go ahead and show the process of me logging out and then logging back in to enable front desk. We have the work app in front of us now, and I can either log out or quit. So we'll go ahead and quit out of this, and I'm going to relaunch the app. We now have the Frontdesk application on our screen. From here, you can see that we still have access to the normal features and functionalities that we had in the normal 8x8 work app, but so there's still calls, there's still the contact lists and messages and so on and so forth. The main difference here is the ability to be able to see everybody at a high level and then be able to handle multiple calls at one time. So we'll go ahead and test this out just a little bit. And I'm going to make an active call. So we'll give my test number a call here real quick. So we see that we have some ring in here and then the numbers up here in the caller ID display. And then this is front and center in our view. So it's pretty neat. Call on hold. And you know what's pretty cool with this is that I can actually now take this call and then send this to somebody else that may need to
Other
take this.
inquiries,
So
press
for
2.
instance, if I want to put this call back on hold and send this over to Nikki Jones, I can do a warm transfer, where that means is I would call Nikki and let her know, hey, you have a call here at the front. I'll go ahead and transfer it to you. Or I can do a cold transfer where I just send that call without letting her know that there's a call coming in. I can also send the call to voicemail, or I can send her a quick message, just basically letting her know that there's a call waiting for her at the front desk. So that's Frontdesk in a nutshell. I'll go ahead and do another one of these videos just to show you how this operates. So this is new to me. This used to be the Switchboard Pro application, so now it's front desk, and I do have some playing around to do with this just to get a little bit more familiar with the setup. But I just wanted to show you how to enable this and what it looks like. So if you have any questions about this setup, let me know. Drop them in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.